அனாகதம் அந்த மணிப்பூரக சக்ராஸ் ஹார்ட் நயன சக்ராஸ் தானந்தரந்தா இஸ் சச் எ சட்டில் சக்ரா தட் இட் டஸ் நாட் ஈல் டு ஆர்டினரி மெடிடேஷன் டெக்னிக்ஸ் இட்ஸ் வெரி சட்டில் நோ மெடிடேஷன் டெக்னிக் கேன் டச் இட் தட்ஸ் வை சோ லிட்டில் இஸ் நோன் அபவுட் இட் ஓபனிங் தானந்தரந்தா ரிக்வயர்ஸ் ஹைலி சோபிஸ்டிகேட்டட் ஈசோட்ரிக் டெக்னிக்ஸ் தட் கேன் ஒன்லி பி பாஸ்ட் ஆன் டைரக்ட்லி ஃப்ரம் த மாஸ்டர் டு டிசைபிள் ஒன்லி அன் என்லைட்டட் பர்சன் கேன் இனிஷியேட் அதர் பர்சன் தானந்தரந்தா தானந்தரந்தா இஸ் அ டோர் டு எ ட்ரெமெண்டஸ் அண்ட் பெரனியல் சோர்ஸ் ஆஃப் எனர்ஜி யங் மீ ஐ டு கெட் ரெடி டு இனிஷியேட் Initiation means mornings I won't eat because it is like a drill bit. When I initiate you, you will feel as small as if a drill bit is just inserted and taken out in this region. Don't be frightened. I will be touching only the third eye, but in that region, I will see that you don't feel frightened. In the very small way only the initiation will happen. That just that anandananda will touch, drill it and it will take. Then you will be able to feel the energy. For some people, even physically, you can feel very clearly. Like a drill bit going in. Mm-hmm. Physically means the feeling you can see. It's like a the energy shaft will be just sent inside. And till your energy, you see, you are passing your annamaya kosha, pranamaya kosha, manomaya kosha, vijnanamaya kosha, anandamaya kosha. When it touches your Atman, then only the drill bit will be taken out. Then from the Atman, the energy will start gushing. You understand the mechanism? Initiation. Anandamanda is the door to a tremendous and perennial source of energy. It is opening something of tremendous and lasting significance. It takes place inside you for the first time. The deepest layers of your beings are opened to the continuous flow of divine power. You truly became a fit to be a channel of the divine. Whenever you go to sleep, if you just do the Anandananda meditation, fall into sleep, you will never have a dreams. You will have a totally deep sleep. And you will have a strange feeling that you have not slept, but you are totally alive, fresh, active. You will have that aliveness. Initiation is no complicated process. Initiation is the key to enlightenment. Initiation is no complicated process. All it requires from your side is an open mind. When initiating you, all I do is open your doorway to enlightenment. Your Anandananda chakra. You can try open this chakra in two ways. By penetrating inward from outside or by pushing outward from the inside. But there is a phenomenal difference between these two. Imagine a lake covered by a thick sheet of ice. The first method is like hacking at the ice with a small ice pick. It could take you lifetimes to break through. The latter method is like a drilling the ice from underneath with a powerful submarine drill. In an instant, the ice gives way and the water gushes out, melting the rest of the ice on the surface. I think I have explained this to you. So, a healing effect of your body will become too much. Once you are initiated into Anandananda and do the meditation, quickly the healing will happen. Anything, you will see that immediately it gets healed. There are two kinds of diseases. Disease which comes from inside and disease which comes from outside. These are all from outside, the accidents. This will quickly get healed. Disease which comes from inside will not come at all. That is the effect of this Anandananda meditation.
Are you saying, Swamiji, that let's say if you're hurt, that you're saying just by doing the daily Anandananda meditation you will be healed, or if you are hurt to do that meditation?
If you are?
Let's say one of us injures ourselves. Would you say that that is a time to do the meditation, or because you do the meditation every
because
day?
Because you do meditation, the healing will be there. Of course, I don't say don't take medication. Whenever it is necessary, give the chemical needs for your body. Medication, I don't say. But the healing effect will be very quick. Highly effective.
Now, why is you don't teach this meditation during the ASP? Not for healers, but just to open that chakra for everybody?
See, it can be opened. But whenever it is given, so easily, they don't have the respect. People don't have the respect. Even many healers don't understand what they receive. Only when you read again and again many books, spiritual books, only when you understand how others have suffered, then you understand their greatness of it. Throughout his life, Ramana Maharshi opened this chakra only for 16 people. Here I already touched more than thousands. Ah, yes.
clear a particular pranayam system?
No pranayam system is not required.
Before you go
this there, itself will be is enough.
Meditation
is enough.
Okay.
The latter can happen only by the grace of an enlightened master, 24th page, 124th page. Who enters the deepest layer of your being and drills outward till the eyes of your chit breaks and the energy floods into your being. Once this energy is available to you, it can transform you physically, mentally and spiritually. During the initiation, do this check yourself. Close your eyes simply and call to mind my smiling face. You will find that a deep source of joy opens up inside you and bliss gushes out into your being. If you allow yourself to sink deeper and deeper into this bliss, you will soon experience the strange feeling of boundlessness, as if you are no longer limited by physical body. See, every day you do 20 minutes of Anandananda minimum. In 4-5 days itself, you will feel that boundlessness. First, experience will have in 4-5 days. Many people get the experience by the initiation itself. After initiation, I will check the energy flow. That time itself, you will have an experience. If you don't feel the experience, your intellectual time, within 2-3 days you will see that you reach that experience. If you continuously do, even in one day, maximum 3-4 days. But I would not like you to take my word for it. This is such a deeply personal experience of the divine that it cannot be understood second hand. It will be impossible for you to believe completely until you have felt it yourself. So try this instead. When you feel the joy rushing upwards, just deny the experience with the whole strength of your mind. Tell yourself it is just your imagination. Every time you feel that surge of joy, push it aside, saying naiti, naiti. Generally people say to believe in all these things. I say don't believe. When you get the experience of Anandananda, try to say no, just I'm imagining, this is Swami hypnotizing us. Try to avoid it. And again, remember, we will see from the same place energy will gush. Then forget, lose another one. And again you try your best to suspect. Beyond your mind the energy will be gushing. Beyond your mind the energy will be gushing. Anything spiritual means, it will act on you beyond your mind. You cannot do it. People ask me, Swamiji, how will I choose my guru? I tell them, don't bother about him. He will choose you. Once you meet your master, simply your mind will be pulled. It is not that you need to go and you need to have the respect and all those things. I always tell the people. And you see, whenever somebody says, respect me as your guru, I am your guru, take me as your guru, please be sure that he is a dupe. Be very clear. Simply you don't have to do anything. When a real master appears, you are simply behind him. Nothing can stop, and how much you try to avoid, you are simply behind him. So whenever real spirituality happens, never the real master asks you to believe, asks you to have faith, no belief. Beyond your control it will happen, only then allow it to happen. And I tell you, always have the doubt, always have the doubt, so that you will not be cheated. If you don't have doubt, you will be exploited by everybody, anybody. Have the doubt. Beyond your doubt, you will be pulled. There is a beautiful story. There was a devotee of Shiva called Sundara in Tamil Nadu. He used to continuously doubt anything and everything. Somebody asked him, why are you doubting so much? Then how will God appear in front of you? He said, if he can't appear beyond my doubt, can't take me beyond my doubt, then what do you say is a God? How can you say he's God? So carry as much doubt as possible. You will see beyond your doubt, your heart is simply flowing to him. Beyond your doubt, you will simply have the experience. That is what is real spirituality. Because doubt is mental level. Enlightenment is spiritual level, beyond mind. So your mind will simply bombard. Not that your doubt will be answered, clear or anything. Simply you are bombed. Simply you are not there. Simply your being has disappeared. That is what will happen. when you really meet with that energy. So don't be, try to have all your doubts. Simply will be taken into the energy. Bring your deepest doubt into play. After a while you realize that no matter how much you try wishing it away, the energy surges up from the same point. Anandaganda is an energy resource beyond the mind's control. In other healing systems, they tell you to believe from here energy is coming. Believe, look, imagine, look deeply. I tell you, don't imagine. Even if you feel that it is coming, try to doubt, no, no, it is not coming. Simply I'm imagining. Avoid. Do some other work. Suddenly, think whether it is coming. Just remember my face and see. Again you will feel, see, from the same place you will come. Again and again and again, beyond your doubts, when it comes, simply your mind will be boggled. You cannot have any more doubts. Only then it's experience. Experience with how much you try to avoid it by your doubt. Beyond that, it simply shines. How much you cover your face and say, no, no, there is no sun, no sun. But simply you will see that the sun is there. That is what is experience. If you have to imagine and it will come, then it's only your mental energy, mental imagination. It's not experience. The beauty of Anandananda is that you cannot remain untouched. You simply surrender to the experience, whether you know it or not, whether you like it or not, whether you believe it or not, truth is happening. You may not understand it now, but once you are in the transformation happens, you will, at the time, both faith and doubt will disappear. I don't tell you to have faith on me. No faith. Let both doubt and the faith, let both disappear. You don't have to believe, you know. Do you need to believe that the sun will rise in the east? You know. Just like it, you will know. I wanted the spirituality to become an experience of your life, not to be a belief of your life. Anandananda meditation, the technique. The uniqueness of this technique is that you can practice it while you are healing. Baba works in his own way. Each one has got their own way, their own one. Each one has got their own mission. We cannot compare anybody's mission to others' mission. People come and ask me, Swami, why Baba doesn't initiate healers? I tell them, you can ask me, why you are not started asking healers?
No,
but
he do it in the beginning, like
that. No, he has done in many years. People come and ask me, why he is not initiating healers? I tell them, you can ask me also, why I am not having hair like that? Or why I am not starting the hospital. Each one is unique expression.
But
you cannot.
But this feeling is very unique feeling. That's what I'm saying.
Anything that feeling is
very
unique. That's what. Everyone that is working in their own way, in their own method. Each, you see, God allows each one a different duty. Each one a different service. Each one of the masters, Dishandhan is here, with a different way of enlightening the people. So, you cannot compare. We must be able to respect everybody. Please be very clear, never disrespect anybody. Never disrespect anybody. Be very clear, if you disrespect anybody, you are disrespecting me. And what for the whole spirituality? To be egoless and simple. People hold on to this and become egoist. And it's like you go to take bath and you put all the mud on your head and come back. In the reverse, people go for taking bath and they roll on the mud and they come out more dirty. Now, like that only we do many times. We come out more dirty. We go to the spirituality to have egolessness and spirituality, meditation, enlightenment. When we come back, we are more egoistic. What type of spirituality? Never do that. Anandananda meditation, the technique. The uniqueness of this technique is that you can practice it while you are healing so that you can simultaneously focus on your own spiritual development and help others to be free of disease. Outwardly healing takes place, inwardly meditation. Place your palm on the patient's chakra which is to be healed. The instruction chart will guide you as to which chakras need to be healed for various diseases. If you are still not sure, simply place your hand on the patient's anahata and commence healing. I'll take care of the rest. question for doctors. Sarasra, you see, when you heal the coma patient, understand. Sarasra and Anahata, but you should never touch them. Just keep the hand like that. Above Sarasra, one hand. Near, just 2 inch. Above Anahata, 2 inch, one hand. You should never touch. And circulate the energy means feel, just give that, meditate, then you will see that energy is passing from both hands, they will meet, you yourself will very clearly feel, they will meet and you will see your hands, both hands are connected by energy, then you can take out the hands, then energy is flooded throughout the system, you understand, till you feel both hands, your hands are connected, you close your eyes and keep, don't touch. Keep like this and start meditating. Till you feel the both hands are connected, go on doing the healing. In 4-5 minutes you will feel. Then you can take out the hand. Patient is flooded with energy, you will come out of the coma. Some 4-5 sessions is enough, I think, for you, your energy. You will, people will come out of the coma. Yes.
So, when you did the healing for me with Swarnanti, she had her hand not only on the front of my heart chakra, on the back also. You have the hand on both sides of the chakra?
Here, the instruction will be there. If it is said Anahata both sides,
okay,
then you need to keep like this.
Otherwise, it's the front.
One front is Anahata. Muladhara both sides, arthritis. So, like that means you have to keep both sides. Whenever it is put both sides, you have to keep both sides. Close your eyes and visualize my laughing face. This is the key which has been programmed to unlock the whole healing process. Whole healing process already programmed. Just you have to put Nityananda password, tuck tuck, over. The whole program is work on its own. And in an instant, you will find energy gushing forth in an endless fountain from your Anandavanda chakra. You will see immediately energy gushes. And then you forget my form. Don't get hold on to my form. Now I have to warn you, beware of Nityananda. First, you have to be aware of Nityananda, remember me. Once you start feeling the energy flow, forget my form, hold on to the energy. Go to the energy. See, the form is so beautiful, blissful, you will never let go of the form. Please don't do that. Hold on to the energy, not to the form. Where energy comes, you just watch there. From where energy comes, you will see that your whole being just merges in the energy itself.
Are you saying we should do the meditation first and then do healing? That's the best way, or not?
Just keep the hand and start meditating. The healing will happen. You understand? Keep the hand. Close your eyes. Remember my laughing face in this area. Immediately you will see the energy gush starts happening. Concentrate where, then just see from where the energy is coming. You will see that automatically the energy flows through your hand, throughout your body. You will have the energy effect. You will have the experience. Then once, after 3-4 minutes, you will feel your hand is automatically, the energy flow is stopped from the hand. And the hand to the patient is stopped. It's like you take a banyan leaf and make it wet with water and paste it on your thigh. After a few minutes, it drops by itself. Just like that, you will feel hand is, the energy is enough. You yourself will feel very clearly. The hand drops by itself, you can take it out.
So you don't need to focus on the patient's condition and think about what they
don't bother at all. If you focus, your mind will interfere. Don't allow the mind to interfere. Just be out of the scene. Not because of you healing is happening. In spite of you, it is happening. Never have a mind.
Friday, never did meditation. One year, and then after initiation, should we meditate for some time before?
Anandaganda. No. Just Anandaganda. If you want, you do Mahamantra once morning, enough. Morning once Mahamantra, evening Anandaganda, that's enough. No more meditation. Yes, perfectly. Once you are initiated, actually, you are. In India, that's why I don't initiate. I prepare them and then initiate. But once initiation is done, that itself creates all the effort. If you do the Mahamantra many times, Anandaka, the effect will be more in the evening when you do it. to remember the laughing face only, the last page, the photo is given. I think it's the last page you can see. Love is the greatest healing power. And I have a devotee in it, who is a cine photographer. Once in 15 days he comes and stays the ashram. From morning till night he will move around with me, with his camera. He captures all these moments. It is not, these are not post photographs. This and even that is not post photograph.
Can
I sit?
Can you explain a little bit on the on this? The Shaka, what's this line, the black line and the white line, and the baby and the Buddha or something?
No, don't bother about the line, the diagram.
Don't bother.
Just you understand the names, that's enough. If you understand the whole thing, then it takes a big science.